Well, poop. Started streaming and I don't even have the name of the video up. Struggle bus, y'all. I'm driving it today. Orange and aqua. Resin. Nope, that's not how you spell painting. Hi, you guys. It's me. It's Erica. It's just me today. Jeff is at somewhere. He's at Makerspace, finally cutting some more things. Coasters, stir sticks, the charms, a lot of the stuff that your orders have been held up on. Thanks. I did put a lipstick on today. It's like the only makeup I have, so don't judge me. Anyways, I've been asked a lot lately, that's fun, about colors that don't really go well together. Well, they look good together, but if they mix, they're horrible. And so I've been inspired lately. Sorry about all the noise. My window's open. Relax. Who Joe's like, what's up? Is this the goodbye? It's not. It's the intro. He's confused. I've been asked a lot about colors like orange and blue or orange and aquas. So I'm going to do like a fall version of those colors. That was Pujo. Sorry about that. Hi, guys. Hi, guys. Hi. Hello. So I'm doing everything today solo. So bear with me. And yeah, let's create some artwork. Oh, I forgot to tell you guys, I'm Erica, this is Artist Till Death. Every day we come on and we paint live, almost every day, try to. Enough. And those are my boys. And yeah, let's create some artwork together, y'all. Boys, relax. I thought that was the other intro. It was not. It's that intro. Sorry about that. Okay, let me move the chat so I can see what y'all are saying. Oh, relax, boys. Go lay down. Okay. Sweet. Looks good. Okay. You think I'd be more prepared for a live by this point, but I'm not. Struggle. It's real. So, today, I'm doing some different colors. They're very different for me. I don't usually do orange. Sorry, I had to get another gallon of resin. I had to go get more of this. I jammed my finger like last month and it's still not fun. So I don't usually do colors like orange ever, but it's fall and people have had requests, so why not? Does this look, I was casting epoxy. I'm glad I noticed that this is kind of a bluish color. I would have, that's more like it. Fun fact, casting epoxy has a slight blue color to it. All right, resin heads, this is 24 by 24, so I probably need, oh my goodness, math. So 6 ounces roughly color covers, a 15 inch. So just to be safe, okay, if you're wondering at home, 3 ounces per square foot. However, I always overmake. I think I'm gonna make 16 ounces. Hey, Shane. See what I just said? Right, that was a very close, almost, whoops. Also, okay, wait. I was having issues with the website yesterday where when people would go to check out, it wouldn't calculate shipping, but it's since been fixed, so I've extended the Bama discount code for 10% for the rest of today. So if that's something you're interested in, go take advantage of it while you can. So the resin I'm using today is StoneCoat Art Coat. It is an awesome resin, super UV resistant, doesn't have any smell to it. Has 2 hour working time and is like 500 degrees heat resistant. It's amazing. It's my favorite. Depending on how many coasters you want to make, right? I always end up making like 100 coasters, but coasters are on my fire sale, some of my best sellers, so I can't even be mad about coasters, right? Have you decided which weekend you're doing the class in Florida? I want to say, let me pull up my, let me check my this. So I'm pretty sure the weekend of the 12th, I'm pretty sure. He is doing shark stingray stencils as well, but he'll be doing that once he gets home rather than at Makerspace. Hey guys, hello, how are you? Thanks for joining me today. I can't see how many people are in here, but I'm almost 1,000% sure that there are less thumbs than there are people in the room, which is crazy because you think everyone would come with two thumbs and they could at least give me one of them. Hint. Anyways, absolutely, Chrissy, I hope you can make it. I think we picked that weekend because a few people said that they could make the weekend of the 12th and not the weekend of the 5th. So that's why we're going with that one. Because we want as many of y'all down there as possible. And if it's more than, I think we're going to do 10 people at a time, and if we can, we'll, like, do the class split. Hi. That's Jeff. Thank you for the thumbs. Thanks. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. Sorry about the motorcycle. I don't hear them at all. They probably come by during the day and I just don't hear them until I go live because that's when I'm focusing on the quiet. How do we register? So I'm going to list it on the website just like any other paint or anything that's on the site, and it'll be for deposit and then the balance is just paid the first day of the class. It'll be a 2-day class. And so you just go to the website and buy your deposit, and that saves your seat for the class. And it's kind of like how we do the online classes, except for this one will be in person. The class will be in Bradenton, which is a little bit just like this much south from Tampa. And then after we get that one out of the way, we're going to do one in Santa Cruz, probably in January. Oh, yeah, Bradenton is super big. There's a bunch of classes. I mean, classes. A bunch of hotels. So, for sure. It's a nice area. It's very retirement-y, but a little bit younger. I mean, there are... It's a lot. It's very eclectic, but there's a million golf courses, etc. Hi, y'all. Anyway, so we are planning on doing the Bradenton class because we mentioned it first, and then right after that, the next one on the list is Santa Cruz. We'll be out there with Gin Germs. And so if you're in the Cali area, be there. We swear. Or even if you're not in the Cali area and you want to just show up. And we're thinking about doing one in Dallas, somewhere in between all of that as well. It's a lot to put on a class. But we're gonna. Santa Cruz, is that New Mexico? It's not. It's like Southern California. It's SoCal. Gin Germs can give you more of like a more geographical description of where it is. Or your son and his family lives in Bradenton. It's a very beautiful area. Hi, Stacy. Has it been 3 minutes? My arm's sore. It's Northern California. See, I don't even know. Science, words, geography. They're all impossible for me. Art, I got you. I can tell you about that, but all that other, I got nothing. So, if you're new to resin, the resin I'm using is a 1-to-1, which means you use equal parts of A and B. You mix it fully and completely for 3 to 5 minutes until there's no like little angel hair swirls. You want it to be fully You want it to be fully mixed together, and that includes scraping the sides and the bottom of your mixing bucket so that you don't get any weak spots in your final piece. Bay Area. There you go. Now you can fly into San Jose. Incorporated. Thank you. See, Clara knows words. A lot of times she's the adult supervision in my life. Cups. Someone remind me I need to order rags and cups. I need like a live-in assistant, but I don't have anywhere for them to sleep. So yeah. Nay-nay, no stress. That's how it is on my birth certificate. I kind of changed it like in high school. I decided it was cooler with a K and it stuck. Okay, so we got that mixed up. So I'm gonna use, I'm gonna use chocolate from Just Resin. Maybe. This is an old jar. Hey, Trish. Sleep with the puppies. The boys sleep under my bed most days. If you ever get a Just Resin pigment that's solidified, just hit it with some heat and it'll melt back to where you can use it. I'm not sure why that happens. They told me, but it doesn't. Science. You need to order resin cups. Y'all, I'm gonna forget by the time this feed is empty, over. You know what I mean. I don't know why I'm doing that when I don't even have resin in these cups yet.
In fact, I'm going to need... This is going to be a nod to the resin pours I did like a year ago. It's very swipe. That one's going to be black. And then I need some bees for the chocolate. I guess I need to use gold instead of copper. What do you guys think? Bright gold or copper for my metallic color? White. Chocolate orange, white. Never need that much aqua. Maybe we will. I don't know. We'll save that. I added hardener to my stiff paste per someone's recommendation. Don't invite it. I wouldn't do that. Gold. All the above. Gold. Metallic. Copper. Gold. Copper. Copper. Y'all are 50-50 right now. When I was looking for like color references for this palette, I ran across Pia's, a piece of hers from Highland Art. Thanks, ma'am. Boy cat, you have to get down. Just trying to get to the window. Something besides gold. What do people see? A different metallic gold lover. Oh, harsh. Okay. Will do. So we'll use copper. No Bowie. Okay, so we got our chocolate color. And I'm going to use Black Passion for the cells. If you guys have never heard of Color Passion, they're a newer brand. That came out this year, I believe, maybe late last year. And all of their pastes act as a cell spurrer. No, it's not. I'm having troubles today. I'm going to need that. Cell enhancer? No. I know as soon as I look up, you guys are going to have the word, so I don't even know why I struggle through this. Silver's too... I think I need something on the gold, copper, bronze, rose spectrum. Just based on what we got going on. I need a dose of Fireball. Activator, thank you. It's too early for Fireball. Y'all won't get any of your orders sent out today. Okay. Then I'm going to use chocolate orange. This is the color that I that was a close one. Jeff's not here to open this for me. This is the color I'm kind of like basing this palette around because I think it's gorgeous, and unless you're, I don't know, it's not a color that I would typically pick to use because I don't do a lot of browns and I don't do a lot of oranges. But it's so pretty, and it's fall, so why not? I do need stir sticks, but Jeff's out there cutting them for me right now. This is like a stunning, stunning color. It's, can you see that on the, look how vibrant that color is. Clara, thank you. What? So great to me. I don't know what I would do without you guys. Always on the move. But isn't that a great color? It is by Color Obsession. And so now I need a white as well. And then I need to know which of these two you guys think would look better. Oh, I haven't done a copper either. Okay, so I'm going to do two more.
Nope.
Three more colors. Which do you think would look better? The dark, darker or the lighter?
Probably the lighter, but also darker would look good, so I'm letting y'all pick.
I don't know these things.
It's not metallic. I can't do multiple lights for some reason. Only one will work if I try. Lighter. It looks like sriracha. Who doesn't love sriracha, though? Y'all are all across the board. Y'all are 50-50 again. Hi, Valerie. We missed you.
Both.
I'm already almost capped out on the number of colors that I use in one piece. Typically, my color palettes are 4-5 on a crazy day. So this palette that we've got going on right now is already exceeding capacity.
They're both pretty opaque. Flip a coin or a paintbrush.
I wouldn't know which side was which on a paintbrush.
White. We're gonna do copper. This copper is from Just Resin.
Use copper in a while. I'm excited to use this copper. As per usual, I'm going to overload my metallic with a can. It just always turns out better for me, the metallics, if I really, really load it up. And since these are epoxy pigments, I don't have to worry about them setting off the resin too soon. That's great.
You guys are seriously, literally 50-50, so I'm gonna get wild and crazy and do both, but if it doesn't turn out, I'm blaming each and every one of you. But we'll make it pretty anyways, so I know it's gonna turn out. Oh, okay. So the darker one is Turquoise by Color Obsession. It is opaque. And it's giving me problems already. Medic. Any tweezers? Or something stabby?
Got him.
It's a beautiful color. I used to use it all the time in everything. But then I got all these comments that was like, why do you always use the same colors? So I had to stop. I didn't have to, but I did to appease the masses, you know, as I do. Any idea the hours of the workshop? We usually do the first day in the afternoon and the second day in the morning. But if we end up with a greater demand, we'll have to do two on each day. So it'll be like a noon class or 11 a.m. class and a 6 p.m. class each day. And if it ends up that we have to split the class, then we'll give people an option of which one they'd like to be in. Okay. You too, huh? This color is called something. I promise I'm even better on most days with words than I am today. I've been sitting on the computer filling orders from sunup to sundown the last 2 days, so I haven't had many interactions with people, and I guess if you don't use it, you lose it. So this color is Cyan, and it is also by Color Obsession. It's a little bit on the blue side as compared to what the outside of it looks like, but I'm okay with it. Price drop on your favorite house in Dallas. Struggle, dude. Cats. All aspects of a good life seem to be happening in Texas. Hollywood's moving to Texas. Well, Texas is pretty great, if I do say so myself. Okay. I've got black, chestnut, chocolate orange, white, turquoise, cyan, copper. I think I need sparkle. I'm gonna put abalone shell in my this. Y'all know what that is. That's our grease the pan. I'm not doing a lot, just a tappy tap. Because I want to be able to see the black through. I just want a subtle sparkle. Abalone shell is very similar to Milky Way, but it's a little bit of a more subtle sparkle. I guess either of them can be subtle depending on how much you put in it. That's what she said. Scared of vipers. Where's vipers? Vipers are here? I haven't seen one. So in the cups, this palette looks pretty freaking amazing. But you never know until you get it down, right? Right. So in my head, I was gonna do like a Pepsi pour and then do a whole bunch of swipes. You guys wanna see that or more of like a dirty pour? What do you guys want? Demo on demand. Can use powder pigments and acrylic paint as well. So Lynn, most acrylic paints are opaque, and because of that, whatever you put in them will get kind of eaten up by the opacity of that paint. You can find a translucent acrylic, then probably. So just try to get some translucentness. Dude, that's my doorbell. Please hold. Cujo, come out. Stop. Or fun fact, we have to change our doorbell sound every few weeks because the boys start to recognize what it is. So right now it's crickets. So as you saw, they figured it out. So we're gonna have to change it again. Our doorbell thing has like 20 different options, many of which I don't ever want to have to use. So I'm hoping that I can cycle through ones that we like. Waste not, want not, y'all. Okay. Sign with a saw. Insert hold music, basically. So I'm just greasing the pan, term coined by my mom, and she was up here last time. She's thinking about coming up here for Thanksgiving. I need to bug her and remind her that she should do that. Because we're going to just parents for Thanksgiving. Nope. Christmas this year. Which is going to be super exciting because his parents live in Kansas. And Jeff is not a fan of snow, to put it lightly. And it's going to be snowing in Kansas like tomorrow through March. So I'm just spreading out this abalone shell and clear on my surface. I don't have any lights on in the studio, so it doesn't look really sparkly right now. It just looks cloudy, but I'll show you guys a true color video when this piece is over. So for the class that we're going to do in Florida, we're just going to basically teach how we usually do the classes, and it's, we take a consensus of what everyone wants to learn, and then I do a demo, and then we teach a class based on what you guys want to learn. So, on my rags. I'm going to wipe my hand on this. So this is high heat. I couldn't get my concentrator nozzle off, so it's on there. I was going to change it to the platypus attachment. Didn't work out. But I'm just popping the bubbles. I'm not trying to move the resin. Thinning it out a little bit because heat thins out resin. Okay, Pepsi pour. So for this Pepsi pour, I'm going to, initially I thought it was going to be a corner to corner, but I think I'm going to go from here to here. Yeah. I'm going to put the black down first. No, I'm not. Yes, I am. No, I'm not. I'm going to put the chestnut down first. Is that what this is? Yes. As you can see, I'm out of practice and totaling this to my mark, which I think is right here. Then I'm going to do the outline with my Color Passion Black, because I'm going to be manipulating my this outward. Then I'm going to add this darker turquoise. It's not dark turquoise, it's just turquoise. I'm going to add the white. I'm putting the white down to kind of separate a little bit the orange and the aqua. because that can turn into a really gross color really easily. I'm gonna put some black through it to further separate again. And then the lighter aqua. Trying to go right on top of that black. I missed it in a couple areas. And just thin lines of this copper for now. If you don't know, metallic colors will take over. So you want to use them just a little bit to see where you're at and then take it from there. Hi, Mary Beth. Pop some bubbles. I'm pretty sure I don't want to use this attachment. Yeah, I don't. I don't want to do that. So, let's get our swiping paper out. If you haven't seen me do a swipe before, this is some swiping paper. You can use any paper you like. This paper I prefer. You can find it on our website along with all these colors. The resin and the board. Artistilldeck.com. And I'm just going to swipe in this direction. I think. I may have put too much black in this because it's already doing a whole bunch of silly things. Try to brighten it up a little bit more of that color. So, I'm just going to lay my swiping paper down. Take my time. Pulling it across the surface. I was really excited about this abalone in the background, but it's starting to look a little galactic. I need to do bigger weights. Can't really see how they look on camera. Not applying any pressure. That one looks better, huh? You guys can see what goes on. Cujo, be sweet to the cat. Silly things. Just that simple. I'm going to end up tilting this. I can tell. You can tell already. So this is not really the copper. That's that chocolate orange. I think I'm going to do a larger swipe. Come along with me, children. I'll take the LA. You know what song that, what movie that song's from? Yes, TG.
Correct. That dark turquoise color is kind of getting lost, isn't it? I'll have to do a dip swipe to pull that color back in. Thank you, Trisha. I feel like I should have painted the base of this brown. That's what I feel like. Okay. I always recommend pulling towards you if you do a swipe. It just makes everything in life easier as opposed to pulling away from you. You're just asking for a mess. I need to add more of this color because it kind of got lost. And some more of this color. And probably the chocolate orange. If you do a swipe and you feel like it's kind of dragging or not moving quite as easily, just hit it with just a little bit of heat to thin it out and should fix that problem for you. Hi Jude. Valerie, we made our own drying rack with something. What was it? Just a shelf we got from Home Depot, and we put a plastic tarp around it. We have a video. Here's a video. Something to that. Let's do this. I'm trying to follow the swipe pattern that I already established. Still lost that aqua color. Okay. I'm gonna put some aqua on my swiping paper. That way, there's no question. It doesn't look very, we'll come back to that. It is not what I'm looking for, but we'll fix it in a minute. Okay. Next. I'm trying to lay my swiping paper down in a few of the different colors that we have going on so that the swipe isn't all one color, because whatever color you land in is going to be the majority of the color of your swipe. Top color always shows through the most. But if you have multiple top colors, they're just not pulling very far, are they? It's fine. Fix it in post-production.
also be that I'm pulling striking paper too fast. Also, I don't think so. I don't know. We'll figure it out together. Have an awesome conference call, Christy. Denise, what's not in your brain? Bye, Nene. No. Not by Nene. By Christy. Yeah, I'm going to put more heat down. Where I just have it looks really cool. Like where it's just doing its thing. So I may still run a dirty pour through this. This may be just one of those pieces that we throw everything at. That one was fun. A little bit of everything. Pretty sure that's what's gonna end up happening. A little bit of swipe, a little bit of tilt. And then a little bit of dirty pour action. Alright, we've swiped it. That's what this swipe looks like. It looks like a Midwestern feather thus far. Arlene, that is chocolate orange. One of my new favorite colors that I'm not sure how to use properly yet. Obvi. So you see all these awesome cells popping up? That's from swiping my colors over the black from Color Passion, and any pigment from Color Passion, as long as it's under your other colors, as you saw in this, the Color Passion was on the outside and I swiped the colors from the middle out so it went over that black, and that's what created the cell pattern. Also worth noting, where the black is on top, there aren't really cells through here and through here. That's because it has to be on the bottom for it to work. This is all black on top right here. You can find all of her colors for all of the awesome cells on my website, artistildeath.com. Shameless plug. Oh my goodness, for a second, I thought the camera was gonna fall. I really hope it doesn't. I don't wanna be in trouble. Maybe as time passes, your resin thickens, you need more heat to in it to get cells. Could be. I've lost my resin courage, but not giving up. Reach out to me. Let's discuss. All right. There's a hair. So I'm feeling a tilt, but I want to know what you guys think. Hey, Sam. Resin can be put on glass. Thanks, you guys. All right. I'm adding a little bit of heat to promote movement. Starting to like it better already. Okay. Now I need to let this rest. We're going to turn it around and tilt the other way. salted caramel yet that I know of. By that I know of means that I remember. I go through so many colors. But it's beautiful in the jar. And breathe, Lisa. Indian summer orange is pretty for sure. Alrighty. So it's still a little bit fluid. I'm gonna give it another minute to rest and get all these hairs out that I'm sure are mine rather than the animals. Thanks, Gigi. Hey, Catherine. I can see dragon's back or dragon's tail. Claire is the expert on dragons though, so I don't try to do those on purpose. Cause then she'll be like, okay, I see what you're doing. And then she'll do it on her channel and it'll look amazing. P.S. if you haven't checked out Claire's channel, make sure you do so. She's a phenomenal artist. All right. Let's get our second side tilt going. I'm heating the resin that's in front of the design, in front of the swipes, and that will help the design stretch uniformly as opposed to just hitting it with the heat. As that abalone shell moves, you can really see it sparkle. I love it. And those cells are stretching out so nice. Get him, Tara. Remind everyone about their thumbs. So I'm letting this tilt off a little bit further than I would normally because I really want the cells to grab the sides of the board. So when I stretch it, tilt it back, it really stretches that cell design. You'll see what I'm talking about. How does the abalone shell compare to diamond dust? They're both beautiful. The main difference is that abalone is like a rainbow of sparkle, whereas diamond dust is white. It's very pearlescent. And diamond dust is slightly bigger particles. Then the abalone, the micron size is a little bit smaller. I'm gonna heat it in some areas just to get the design to be not so leaf-like. So there's this part in the middle where that black is that I'm trying to stretch out. Because that's going to be in the center of the piece and I don't like it. why having a resin that has such a long working time is so amazing. So you don't really have to worry about it seizing up on you mid-painting. I already like it better. But I'm still having a hard time enjoying this very uniform. That, I need to switch gloves, this is bothering me. So, I think I need one of those, you know when you go bowling and like, I have no idea, but like pro bowlers, they stand with their hands in front of that fan before they put their hands in the bowling ball, which is also bananas because usually they don't even put their fingers in the hole. I need one of those, is mine. Because when I switch gloves, they don't go on proper and I end up with gloves that look like this. Thanks, y'all. Thanks. It doesn't help that they pack these gloves in like sardines. Probably more, they pack them in like pickles. So you guys can see these cells really have stretched out. That aqua color with the chocolate orange really am down for. Bam, I knew you'd catch that. I'm good. Thanks, JJ. Okay, I have loosened my camera somehow. I'm just gonna have to fix it. Maybe I can figure it out. I don't know. We'll see. Nope. Wasn't it? No, maybe it's this one. So, since it's going to be difficult, I'm just going to have to work with what I got and do this. Oops. Smart. Look at smart. Galaxy Flare, I like it. Galactic, I also like it. But I'm not digging these uniform peaks, I guess. I don't know where that glare is coming from. But you see what I mean? So I think I'm going to do a dirty pour somehow through those areas. And if you don't know, dirty pour is when you take all the colors you're working with, put them in a cup, and you pour it out. It's gonna get dirty, but isn't everything? Hey, Roxana. Okay, let's start with what color we want on top, which is gonna be the aqua. Which, I mean, I guess I could have just used the aqua that is in here and not poured it out onto this. Live and learn, though. Live and learn. Okay. And then, let's break it up with white. Then let's do chocolate. A little bit of the black. Chocolate, oh, nope, the turquoise. And then the chocolate orange. We're gonna give this concoction a swirl. You don't wanna mix it up, we just want it to have some movement. All right, how are we gonna do this? I think Jeffrey's home. Hi, Bee. Y'all, if he was an intruder, everyone would be dead. Okay. I'm gonna do this a little bit on the side, just see what it's gonna look like. I'm using chocolate orange and it looks like that.
Are you real?
I don't know. So let's do. This is one of those times where it's like, should I know when to stop? I need to make sure I have a backup plan in case this dirty pour doesn't work out. I need to have an exit strategy. Because it has turned this into some funky green color. I'm glad we did kind of a roadside because that's not a cute color. I'm gonna leave it out. I'm gonna not do that. I'm gonna cover it up with black. Fun fact, orange and aqua made duck poop green. Just because you make a color doesn't mean you have to use it, people. Hey y'all. So I think I'm just gonna break it up with a swipe and not, I'll use a dirty pour on a coaster so it's not wasted. What made that orange color. Okay, be careful if you use cyan and that chocolate orange, it will make funky green. This may just be how this piece ends up. Let's add some more copper accents and we'll just call this piece finished. Well, Lynn, I am happy to have been informative for you. We're always here to help. We go live every day. to answer all of your resin queries. Queries? Queries is a good word.
Oh, wait.
I'm glad we went with copper.